This is the PilotFish EDI console. It's the integrated development environment you'll use to build, test, maintain, and deploy all of your integration interfaces. For this video today, we'll be looking at the sample supply chain EDI workflow doing some purchase order ingestion. So we'll be taking in some EDI, doing some field validation, a little bit of tweaking, and then updating a database, and then also sending an acknowledgment back to the sender. So let's get into it. So opening up our route here, you'll see our main route grid, and this is where you'll do the majority of the construction of your route. So this is where you'll define your source and target systems, you'll set up your validation, work in the mapper, all those sorts of things. And so how this is organized is we have our source systems on the left. So this is all the places that we're taking data from. We have our target systems on the right. These are all the places that we're sending data to. And then the data enters the system and flows through the seven-stage assembly line process as it's finally sent to its destination system. So for this route here, as we could see, overlooking at our sources, so we're picking up some EDI X12 from our SFTP. And looking at our transport systems, our target systems, so here we're updating our purchase order archive database, and then in our second target system, we're sending that 855 acknowledgement back to our sender. So at this point, let's look at each of the seven stages and the role that they play in the integration process. So the first stage on the far left, the source system stage, this is mainly documentational. So for each of our different source systems, we can give it a name, some metadata if desired, and also a customized icon. So this is very useful when you're working collaboratively on these different routes to be able to quickly identify the source and target systems, what they're doing, where the data is coming from, all those sorts of things. So next we'll move into the first functional stage of the integration pipeline, and that's our listener stage. So obviously if we want to integrate some data, the first thing we have to do is we have to get that data, and we use the listener stage for that. So we have these pre-built listeners for all different kinds of ways that you could imagine to get data into the system. So whether it's something like an FTP, as we're using here, maybe a directory, an email, database query, something from the cloud like AWS or Google Cloud Engine, any way that you can imagine getting data into the system, we've got a listener for it. And so how all of our different modules work is they take a base level of configuration. These are our required field values. And then there's more advanced configuration with same defaults if needed. So for our FTP listener here, all we really need to set up is our host port, our credentials, how often we want to pull, and then it's ready to go and receive files. So next we move into the processor stage. And the processor stage is where we perform any pre-transformative operations on this data. So let's say we're getting our EDI from our SFTP and maybe it's encrypted, it's in some foreign character encoding, or maybe it's in a zip file we need to decompress. And so we'll chain processors to perform all those sorts of operations so that when we get to our next stage, we know that the data is ready for transformation. And so here in our purchase order workflow, we're using an asymmetric decryption processor with some conditional execution to say, in case my EDI payload that I'm picking up is encrypted, I want to go ahead and decrypt that before I send it on to the next stage. So next we'll move into the source transform stage. And so the purpose of this stage is to take any non-XML formats and convert them into an XML structure that we understand. And so we do that in a two-part process. Where first we use a transformation module to take any non-XML formats and give us kind of a baseline XML representation. And then second, we do a logical mapping. So this is an XML to XML mapping using our data mapper. So since we're ingesting some EDI here, we're using our EDI transformation module. We're supplying the X12 table data for the transaction that we're trying to work with, in this case 850. And then we're also, since we're dealing with EDI, we're going to add some enhancements to the XML that we're producing. So we're going to use our friendly naming here to add some more human-readable friendly names to that XML that we're producing. And then we're going to also add some segment indexing just to help us later on with our mapping. And so as I mentioned, the second piece of our transformation stage is this logical mapping using our data mapper, which I'll show now. So here we have our data mapper. This is our three-pane graphical drag-and-drop mapping tool. How this is organized is we have our source format on the left, so this is our incoming expected XML structure. We have our target format on the right, so this is the XML structure that we're trying to produce. And then you drag and drop from the left and the right, and using the tool palettes at the top for more complicated operations to construct your mapping. So here, since we're taking in some EDI, We've got our EDI XML format here on the left, so you should recognize our loops here, our PO1 CTT from that incoming 850. And then what we're doing in this mapping here is we're doing some field validation. So we're not changing the structure at all. We're just adding on to that structure if any of our validation rules aren't met. So our target format is also that EDI 850. And so what we're doing here is we're using an identity template to essentially copy over all of the XML. So we're copying directly across. And then for any of our loops or defined elements that match, we're going to perform this validation rule. So here we're doing a pretty simple validation rule to say, get the count of all of our PO1s and make sure that they're equal to our total. So we're saying, if my line item total doesn't equal the count of actual line items that I have, then I want to go ahead and identify with this CTT versus PO1 mismatch text attribute. So a little more about our data mapper. Under the hood, this is all generating W3C compliant XSLT, so there's no binary formats. This will run in any XSLT engine. Also here in the data mapper, we have a built-in testing mode. So you can feed in a sample file as I've done here. You can push go and then immediately see the results of that incoming data pushed through our mapping that we've put together. So taking a step back, we ingested our data via the listener. We transformed it into that XML in the source transform, did a little field validation. And next we move into the routing stage. So the routing stage performs a couple different operations. But the main one that we're going to focus on here is our routing rules. So routing rules is our primary way of taking our incoming source data and sending it only to the target systems that we want. So we can define these arbitrarily complex routing rules to say, based on either some information in the transaction, maybe some metadata that we've set, what have you, follow these rules and flag the ones that match, and then only send the data to those certain target systems. So here I've got a couple simple rules set up. So my first rule here is looking at that EDI XML and saying if my BEG07 is AC, so if my sender has requested an acknowledgement, then I want to send this message to my second target system here. And otherwise, I just want to go ahead and in all cases send it on to the database transport. So we'll always be updating our database, but only if our sender wants an acknowledgement will we send the data onto the second target system. So moving into the target side, it operates basically the same as the source side, but in reverse. So first we're doing our target transform using a logical mapping here, and then we're using our transformation module to produce any non-XML formats. For instance, here looking at our second target system, since we're producing that 855 response, we're using our logical mapping to map into that 855 XML, and then we're using our EDI transformation module to actually produce that final EDI. So next, looking in the transport system, these operate analogous to the listener, where we're pushing data to a target system. So for instance here, since we're updating this purchase order archive database, we're using our database SQL transport to perform these database inserts. And then in our second target system, we're using our HTTP POST transport to send our 855 response back to this target URL. And then our last stage over here, target system, this is identical to the source system where we can give each of our target systems a name, an icon, and some metadata. So now that we've got all of our pieces in place, let's see this in action. Here in the console, we also have built-in testing mode. So this runs byte for byte identical to the EI platform, the headless runtime execution engine. So there's no compilation necessary to test your routes here. Here in the testing mode, you can start and stop your test from any stage. You can feed in alternate data and transaction attributes to test those crazy edge cases. And you can also save your testing configurations for easy replayability later. And so that's what I'll do here using this sample 850 file that I'm feeding in. So when I hit execute test, we'll see the data move left to right through the system, and we'll get green checks for any successes, and then we'll get red X's in the event that we have any failures on any stages. So here, as I said, looking at the data quickly, so here we're starting with just a basic single line item EDI 850. And then next we'll move into our EDI transformation stage. So this is that transformation module where we took that incoming EDI, transformed it into this XML structure. And here we can see the friendly names that I mentioned earlier, where each of our segments and elements has this really easy to understand, human readable friendly name attached to it. So next we move into our validation stage. And as we can see, all we really did was copy the data over. And then if any of our validation rules would have not been met, we would have had that extra element that we would inject into it. But since since here our number total line items equals the number of purchase line items, we didn't break our validation, so there's no change here. Next, moving into the routing stage, so we can see that since our 850 message included that AC, we did end up sending to both of our target systems. So here, looking at our database target, so here we're using our XSLT to interact with, to produce some SQL XML. So this is an XML representation of database operations. So here we've taken that 850, we've transformed it into these two insert statements saying, I want to insert into this transaction table, and here's that my summary purchase order information. And then down here, my second insert, I'm going to insert into my order item table, and I'm going to use the identity from this first insert as a foreign key, and then here's some more information that I want to insert into my order item table. So looking at our second target system, here we're using XSLT to generate our 855 message, and then looking at the results of our EDI transformation, so here we see we've produced that EDI 855 message that's ready for sending. And so it looks like our transport here was successful, so our database operations worked, but it looks like we had a failure here on our post transport. And so for any places where we have errors, we can view the stage output there, and we can get a really detailed exception message to tell us exactly what went wrong so that we can go back, fix the issues as needed, and then run our test again. So that's really all there is to it with the eiConsole here in this purchase order ingestion. To recap, we took in some EDI via SFTP, we transformed it, did some field validation, and then we updated our purchase order archive database, and we sent our 855 response back to our sender. And it's really as simple as that. In just under 10 minutes, we were able to build, test, and deploy this purchase order ingestion interface using the PilotFish graphical automated assembly line process. Visit our website to download a free 90-day trial of the eiConsole and test it out for yourself. Thank you.